What's up everybody, this is ZmonGaka89, and I'll be starting a line of videos called Tooltorials. Now, to start things off, I'll be making my first video on the most basic manga tool any mangaka can have, and that's the G-Pen. Now, the G-Pen is what I like to call the modern day quill pen. Obviously, this is made out of wood, and it doesn't have a feather on the top, but still, the nib still has the same functionality as a regular quill pen. Now I'll demonstrate to you how the G-Pen works. So the G-Pen is shaped in a triangular shape, like this. And let's just say this is a line, and this is the G. And over here, this is where the ink is held. Now, if you pressed the G-Pen harder on the paper, the pen would become like this. The two ends would separate, thus making the line wider. Okay? And if you just write with the G-Pen like this, the line will obviously be thinner. The great thing about the G-Pen is that depending on when you press harder, that will also depend on when your line is thicker. So you can freely go like this, a thin, and then a wider line, and then a thin, and wider line, and a thin, and wider line. And this depends on how hard you press the G-Pen. So if you want the wider line, you would press hard. And if you want a thinner line, maybe you wouldn't write as hard on the paper. Now, success with the G-Pen is practicing freehand lines a lot. Drawing with different thicknesses, drawing different patterns, or just drawing lines. And the G-Pen can take some getting used to, but after you practice a lot, it will seem almost natural to you. So I'll be showing you an example of some exercises you can do. Now, this is ink, and you take the nib, and obviously, you dip it into the ink. So, let me get some. Okay. Now, the trick to getting a nice straight line is by moving your whole arm, not just your wrist, because your wrists might be shaky sometimes, and that might make the line very scratchy. So you want to just use your arm and move in one fluid motion. So let's see if I could get the pen ink too. Okay, so oops. Looks like it ran out. And you can practice with different thicknesses too. Try doing different patterns and also at different thicknesses. This will help you get accustomed to drawing different things with the G-Pen. So say you were gonna draw someone's face. The side of the face would be thinner than like the part of it that's facing you. you need to learn how to get the dimensions correct, or else there will be no success. I think, in my opinion, G-Pen is one of the most difficult pens to get used to because of how many line variations it has and how many hand techniques you need to learn to get those line variations. Here's another exercise you can do. And just keep practicing it until you think you've got the hang of it. Alright. Now when you are done, the most important thing to keeping the G-Pen in the best condition it can be is cleaning it, and cleaning it properly. There are many ways to clean it. You can rinse it in water or dip it in water, but it seems that whenever I rinsed it in water, water would get stuck in between the creases, and the water would stay there and just rust the pen, since the pen is metal. So the best way that I found out, or that I think, to clean the G-Pen is by using rubbing alcohol. Now, what you can do is either use a tissue or a cotton ball, and just use whatever rubbing alcohol you have. I mean, this is some rubbing alcohol from ShopRite. It doesn't matter which one you use. And what you will want to do is just slightly pour just a little bit on the tissue. And you will want to clean the pen with it. Now this is the most effective, I think. To me, it's the most effective way of cleaning your G-Pen. And rub it all around to make sure no ink gets stuck in any place, because the ink will stay there, leave stains on your pen, and eventually rust it. That happened to my first G-Pen nib because I didn't know how to take care of it very well. Make sure you get everywhere that has ink. And make sure when you're finished cleaning, it has a shine to it. Because when it does, that means you have cleaned it well. Another lazy way to clean it is by licking the tissue and wiping it with your spit. That may sound gross. Yes, I know. I used to do it. It is pretty gross. But, that's like the cheap and stupid way to clean it. That's the lazy way to clean it. And I don't recommend doing it. But I did it a couple times with a G-Pen nib. And it was fine. But then I realized that wasn't the best way to clean it. So I started using rubbing alcohol. Now, as you can see, it has a nice shine to it, thanks to the rubbing alcohol. Now, as you may know, there are many G-Pen brands out there, or brands that make manga pens, and the three that I know of are Tachikawa, Nikko, and Zebra. This right here is a Nikko brand, and it's pretty good, but I'll be explaining to you the comparison between the three brands of G-Pens. Now, the Tachikawa G-Pen, you can get uniform vertical and horizontal lines with this pen, but it has a hard, direct touch. And with the one I'm using, the Nikko G-Pen, the pen, I'd say, is very smooth and has easy flow. It's suitable for drawing thicker rather than fine lines. And the Zebra G-Pen, both fine lines and thick lines can be drawn with this pen. Its soft touch produces soft lines, so Many cartoonists use this pen, although you may feel a slight resistance in flow. Well, that's about it. I'm about to wrap up this video. The next tutorial video that I'll make is going to be on the Cabra pen. And if you want to purchase these G pens, I'll put a link in the description to which websites would be best to purchase the G pens, alright? This is Zimangaka89, and I'm out. Also, if you have any additional questions regarding the G pen, don't feel afraid to post a comment below. Thanks, guys.